if y'all want to give me like 5 seconds. Do you guys want to do a random encounter while we wait on Jake?
That's perfectly fine.
Yeah. So create a new page.
Hi, Ron.
Hey, we're doing it! Finally!
We are...
Yeah, I know. It's been a long time coming.
Yeah,
Yeah. Jake did not be a bitch.
Alright, here's what we're gonna do. Y'all are riding in a carriage on your way. Since we gotta waste a little bit of time as we're... fucking horse.jpg, yes.
Let me...
Please.
Up here.
Horse.jpg. Yeah, Antonio's going through my mic right now, and my mic's kind of... It decided it just wanted to fall apart yesterday.
Yeah, it decided to fall apart.
You were there. You literally saw, like, I'm going to pick it up and then just collapse in my hands.
You're right.
So, I'm going to drop all your characters in. Very good.
Should probably have my character sheet up. And a notepad.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, we forgot to do something for you. So I'm going to grab a very generic... What race is your character?
Human.
Ronnie? Alright, we're going to get a human brawler, so your character has a picture that isn't...
Do I have a picture yet?
I should
have a picture.
Yeah, you do.
Mine?
I love that picture, by the way. No, Antonio's. Yours is good, too, but Antonio's probably fits his character the best.
Yes, it was a very good picture.
We're just going to grab a pretty generic one for now, since that's going to be...
Oh, cool, there's two of me!
Edit. I have to use a file. Save.
No, let's not have two abates.
There shouldn't be, I only dragged...
There's two of me!
There's two archer dudes. Where am I?
I think they're carriage.
Y'all should... Yeah, so, one second. I'm trying to figure out where I put everything.
Just patience, my friends. That's all it takes.
Did I not- Oh, you know what? I went to the new page and forgot to move everyone here, I think. Yeah, there we go.
Move us to carriage, JPEG!
I did!
The entire scene disintegrated.
And of course, Antonio's a fire character. I knew it. He has an obsession with pyromancy.
Yes.
I really like my hexes.
So we have a chameleon man, a fireman, and a purple silhouette.
You can't hide under me. I'm too small for that.
Did it not?
I'm the size of Dwarf Antonio.
Alright, let me...
Edit token. Oh god, I don't want to edit my token.
Okay, I'm trying to give your character a token. I don't know why it's not doing what it's...
Yeah, fuck her on a wagon.
Supposed to?
How do I attack the horse?
So for now, Scrib is going...
They don't know who Scrib is.
you guys have been sitting in a wagon. I assume it's been pretty quiet, considering you were all told to meet up
Get
at a certain...
Get your tokens in the wagon!
You were all told to meet at a certain location, and you were greeted by... Did I do something stupid? No, I didn't. I did not delete. You were greeted by a very weird-looking rat man who kept looking to the left and right erratically and constantly without looking...
Hold up, is the purple
people.
Silhouette me?
He simply
because...
motioned. Yeah, I don't know why Roll20 isn't giving you a token. It's using the silhouette for now.
Okay, well, I'm just going to be, like, sitting in the corner of this wagon or whatever, just, like, writing up on a piece of paper. I'm not going to show it to you guys, though.
The Ratman is also, despite constantly looking around, he's twiddling with his thumbs and his feet are on... It's a very weird posture he's adopted. Every part of his body that could be moving or twiddling with something is doing.
I'm just gonna move my eyes to my sides and just stare at the human and the dragonborn next to me.
What? What do you want?
Wait, do...
No, I'm a chameleon man. That's why I'm able to do it.
Controller? Oh, yeah. Your eyes are able to move independently. That's really wonky.
So is nobody going to question the rat man that just walked up?
Speak Draconic.
You can speak.
Hey, he
just goes, I'll be your guide to the party.
Oh.
Party? Okay. Well, what's a party?
It's a little gathering of a lot of minor nobles and no one too important.
Nobles.
I'm in.
You know the thing you got invited for?
I'm not familiar with all these civilized terms.
Alright, well, just go along with it.
Yes.
Just go along.
So you were saying?
Man, this chameleon's dumb.
She goes, so the plan is you arrive, there will be a very loud and angry dwarf that you will hopefully not get killed by. He's going to test all of you combat-wise.
Okay. Sounds simple enough. Wait. Can we kill him or no? Test dwarf.
What test man?
The one we're supposed to fight.
I don't think that's okay. That's a very
I'll
good
keep
idea.
That in mind.
He's
if I were to accidentally kill him.
His ghost would laugh.
Okay, cool. I'm in. Let's go.
That's cryptic.
But the wagon starts off. You notice a distinct lack of a driver.
Hey guys, I think these horses are like moving by themselves.
Yeah, we couldn't hire a driver.
Okay.
No one we really trusted enough.
Smart horses, then. That's pretty cool.
Oh, no. There's... I would have expected that
so,
to be your first...
So, wait a minute. If the horses are moving on their own, then are we actually going to our destination?
Yes. I can guarantee these horses won't get
I'll
us
I'll take
there.
Your word for it. And I kind of just go back to writing in my little piece of paper.
As the mage says...
What kind of magic?
What kind? The kind that
oh,
mages...
Oh, by the
use.
Way, what can I call you guys? You don't seem to be answering. I'm Scrib. Scrib Pelham. It's a nickname, because I always write on these maps... they're kind of rough as of now.
You can go ahead.
It's like scribe without the E.
You got it.
Wow. Funny rat. Who's this weird eye guy?
Call me Toll.
I don't know what that is.
Toll? Toll.
Kind of like a toll booth?
You're a fucking tool? No, he's just a massive...
I got it. Okay, I got it.
I take my eyes off them and just look through my provisions.
Yeah, hello, I am Cephas.
I'm going to remember you as Cephas.
My job is to...
Yeah, me too.
Ouch. Cephas.
Sorry, little rat. So that's what happens when you can't sit still.
Damn. Well, I'm here to make sure you make it to your destination, and when we get there, I'm here to make sure nothing goes too horribly awry.
I have a question.
Yeah?
What other kind of weird shit do you do with these horses?
Experiments?
That sounds crazy. I'm leaving. Goodbye, I am no longer talking to you.
Civ.
Yeah, we're actually having trouble hearing you guys. You cut out through your mic.
Let me actually see if I can fix my mic. Oh, I just opened up the wrong window. That would be a problem. Discord. Voice and... Oh, input device at 100%. But are you guys going to hear a lot more static? But this
Antonio, check your device. You're the quietest.
Yeah, I'm talking through Mason's mic.
Yeah.
Because his is really super sensitive, and I'd rather not have you guys...
But I like your voice.
But,
called gay.
Well, While you guys are passing time by being a motley bunch of
talking about Discord.
You hear the...
Sorry.
You guys suddenly feel the carriage come to a direct stop.
Is this our destination? What was it, Sithis?
Yes and no. We're about a good mile away.
Could I do a perception check while they're talking?
Yes. It wouldn't be perception. I think it'd be investigation.
Ooh, I don't know. Should I have a lot of wisdom? I'm on this.
I'm on this. Actually, yeah. Everyone roll. I think it'd be investigation check. Man, of all the days to pack up my D&D manuals, this was.
I got a 5, and it would be an add-on on my wisdom, right?
You can actually roll
my sheet. You
know. It's a wisdom check, right?
How do I roll through my sheet?
I got a 6.
No. You click on the skill.
Which skill?
I got a fat 9.
Okay. Alright, here, let me pop open.
I see how it works. Nice.
Yeah, character sheet, and then you can just click on, like, say you want to use animal handling, you can click on animal handling.
Oh, okay.
I don't have a sheet, so I can't demonstrate. I have to. Oh, okay. You hear a very distinct language. It's very crude, and it also involves a lot of smelly greenskins.
Like in the forest or on the carriage or something? We're still in the carriage.
I'm just gonna say out loud, greenskins.
Greenskins?
In a harsh, disgusted tone.
You guessed that there's about a good 3 or 4 outside of the carriage.
Alrighty.
We can just hear the language.
You can hear them trying to whisper, but they're not quite smart enough to have got the idea of whispering.
Yeah, we got green skins out there.
See, this puts us just has a look of pure disappointment on his face, and he goes, "God damn it."
I've heard of these things from my father, but I've never seen one before. So I guess they'll die pretty easy.
They're pathetic.
I should probably get some kind of accent going.
Oh, here, let me go ahead and... Because this isn't the sheet I'm used to. Initiative should be just clicking on where it says initiative with your character sheet clicked. Alright, where is the combat order button? Here we go. Turn order. Ascending, can I please, will it, how the fuck, I haven't used this in a while, and also use the shortcut Control U.
Do I?
Control U. So what did you all get? So Antonio got a 9, Ronnie got a 7, and Abate got a 5, Yeah, I messed that up. D5, D20. So, we got a 3. 5. 13. 15. It should be doing the combat order, but it doesn't seem to want to. First up is a... Wait, no. Why is it doing this? There we go. So first up, one of the goblin archers decides he just kind of sits back and fires an arrow.
We're still in the carriage. Is he like firing at?
Yes. He launches an arrow into the carriage, and miraculously, it finds a weak point in the wall and goes straight through and hits a bot right in the arm.
You okay?
Sorry? What? You cut out, Mason.
One of the goblins just shot through
the crossbow kind of just went through.
Amazing weak point in the carriage and shot you in the arm.
Oh, I should be fine. I have a armor class of 14?
It was a 20.
He rolled a 20.
Oh. It was a 20.
So I think that'd be what? 4 damage? No, wait. I forgot to roll the other.
Oh, that's 4 not damage, that bad. Yeah. I'm perfectly fine.
It's not.
So you're just like shrugging it off, and we're just seeing an arrow. I'm more like
pulling it out of my arm.
You're hard durable, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, the other goblin steps up. He sees what his buddy just did and is in raw disbelief and refuses to fire out of fear of crazy shit happening.
Okay.
And he's also terrified by the lack of a noise from the man who just got pinned by an arrow. These goblins decide they're just gonna move up a little bit.
Not gonna attack the horses or anything, they're just gonna walk up next to him. So they only care about the cargo.
Yep, and on that case, it's Antonio's turn.
Alright. I'm gonna... Oh god, where did my character... Okay. I'm gonna hop out of the carriage, right? And I'm gonna cast Scorching Ray. Which is three beams. And I'm gonna hit the two archers and the swordsman that's closer towards us.
Alright, can you... If you left-click on it, it should put it in the chat so I can read all of it. Oh no, that's terrifying.
Jesus Christ.
So that's seven to hit, right? Or... I can't... I don't like the way this one does it. It's nowhere near as cleanly as the other one, but it's way more stable. Is that two hit? Is that what the seven's supposed to be?
I don't know.
20 plus. Well, so three beams, you're aiming for the two archers.
And the one swordsman that's closer towards
you. Alright, so you hit the two archers. One of them drops dead. The one on the right falls to the ground and just... The proper word would be immolation, right? His body begins to burn to an absolute crisp. The goblin manages to gather his brains for long enough to block, and his shield turns a very disgusting bright red, but he's fine for the most part. Wait, Antonio, did you want to move, or are you just...
I said I jumped out of the cave.
Yeah, so you'd just be right there. Still have 25 more feet if you want to do anything.
No, I'm gonna
just stay there. Alright, so that goes to Ronnie now.
Okay, I want to jump out of the carriage to the right, and I want to fucking just rip this guy's head off. Well, when I say rip this guy's head off, I mean like... Punch him, and then punch him again with old 1-2.
Alright, so you're just going for a really heavy 1-2 in the face?
Rip his head off if I kill him.
Alright, I want to see the roll for this. Make sure to move your token out in front of
Getting out in front of the horsey. How do I determine the roll modifiers?
It should be... Actually, should already be on your sheet. Let me see. There you go. Oh, you rolled a 1.
Did I?
Yes. If you mouse over it, you can see it. I need to fix... No, is it? Shouldn't be there. Wow. You rolled a 1. You hop out, and you charge him, and you go to hit him. You're aiming at a human's head, not a goblin's
head. So I just wasn't ready for it then.
You just whipped right over him. What a great
first combat roll, my god.
Oh, wait, you used the old 1-2?
Not at this point, no. Yeah, I'll use it. I'll use it. Just waste a moxie point, sure.
20! God damn it.
How about that? Okay.
How about that?
Okay, well, I was a little disoriented at first, but I got my bearings.
So you took the first swing, you're like, oh, wait a minute, and with your...
Oh,
your
you remember what I said about not never seeing goblins ever? I guess it can relate to that.
Yeah, it works here. You don't tear his head off, but he goes flying to the right and face just onto the ground. He was not expecting that.
Got a lot of...
And Unless you... I don't think there's anything left for you to do unless you want to, like, bonus action, but that'd be drinking a potion.
Or I want to, like, walk over and stand over this guy just floored. Like, ready for him.
Yeah, you have a, you can do that.
Just, like, menacingly.
I need to do something later. So now it's this, the other goblin. He runs up and tries to save his buddy.
I already modified that.
Oh, he swings and you just kind of, you know, that really casual dodge people do where yeah. they just lean to one side. That's all you really have
just,
to do. To dodge
he just
this.
Like does a pathetic little midget, not midget. These are orcs, right? Oh.
No, they're goblins. They're
orcs. Okay, well, he tries his little midget swing, and I'm like, what the fuck are you trying to do? Get away from me.
Get a grasp on yourself. In frustration, he decides to take a page from Captain America's book and throws his shit.
Oh, Captain America, how far are you falling?
Uh-oh.
Okay, Captain America, what does Captain America do?
He gets fucked.
I'm sorry. He goes to throw the shield, but he actually doesn't release it, and he whacks himself in the face.
You kind of cut out there. All I heard was whacks himself in the
face. He goes to throw the shield. Yes, he goes to throw the shield, but he doesn't actually throw it. And he brings his hand around really close to his head.
Oh, he forgot about the strap or something?
Yes, he forgot
that God damn it.
Wearing a strap.
Bad news about Jake.
Okay, I'm laughing at this guy. I've ceased the menacing stuff, and I'm just straight up laughing at this idiot.
I'm just like, God, these failures of human beings.
They're not humans, they're goblins.
I'm sorry.
That's about average.
Yeah. Alright, so that makes...
Oh, it's my turn now, is it? Is the fucker who shot me in the arm still alive? Let's just go out to the front here, you know? And let's just start off big. Fucking thunderwave them.
Wait, whoa. So are you gonna, like, try and hop through the carriage wall that got shot through?
Oh, no, I'm just walking out the door, moseying up, like, with my walking stick, and I'm just about to fucking shock him in the face. Through Antonio's side.
Oh, three on the other side, then you're fine. So you're just gonna walk out and... Oh, God. With the arrow sticking out of the arm, he has to do a saving throw. Or D20. DC 5, he fails.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait, Thunderwave? Wait a minute. Which one is Thunderwave? Is that the
cone.
Target?
Or
is
it's that the a big area of effect.
It's the cone?
It's in front of me.
It's not around you, right? It's wherever you're pointing. Oh, no. So... The other goblin skin fries to a crisp. The one that shot you is just dead. Like, this man... Lightning did indeed strike twice.
Fucking deserved it.
The other one is in an exceptional amount of pain, considering he's wearing metal armor. And he didn't pass. Actually, I haven't rolled for him. Let me check. Roll d20. Oh, yeah, he did not pass that. He is shrieking in pain at the fact that he just got zapped. Yeah. However, now it's his turn. He's going to try and shake off the fact he just got zapped. And runs up and swings at you.
Oh. Oh, no.
Yeah, he misses. You actually catch his blade with your walking stick, and you realize right then and there, his blade is exceptionally dull, and he's not swinging with very much force. In fact, you're pretty sure he hurt himself in that exchange.
I'm just gonna look at him disappointed. That's all I can do.
Cethus just raises an eyebrow and goes, and he looks out the window and goes, Good job, recruits! Is this... The goblin that was on the floor he stands up. And he really goes for the swing. He just got sent flying. He's angry.
Oh, no.
Oh. And wait a minute. You have, I'm trying to remember. Ronnie, you do have an ability, I think, that allows you to try and block an attack. Do you? Let me make sure. It would be... No, it'd be core. So, Ronnie, if you want... I'm trying to figure out where it is.
What? If I want...
Don't you have an ability where you can, I could swear that... You might not have it unlocked yet, but I... Brace up, old one too, stick and move, street smart. Squared circle.
Is it like dig deep or something?
Okay. No, it's in the I thought you were the other one. The one that's all about knocking people out. So yeah, he gets a nasty little swing in.
Okay.
Only does 5 damage though.
Okay, I'm kind of laughing.
Like
even like a straight shot, that wasn't much. I'm like coughing a little bit, but
for a little goblin, that was a lot.
I'm kind of impressed.
However, suddenly realizes that just the golf clap's going. I'm just like, good job, kiddo. Maybe you'll hit me harder next time. Well, that makes it Antonio's turn.
I don't know how far I'm able to move.
I think it's 30 is usually standard, unless you have any kind of,
Well, how far is this to next to Ronnie?
You see the measuring tool on the... There's, like, fourth down.
I think I just got my moxie point back, right? For taking 5 damage?
Yeah. I think you might have got
it. Isn't it, like, half of my level to get a moxie point?
Yeah, it's like you got to take half your level.
Yeah, I just got my moxie point back.
God damn. That is an investment and a half right there.
Guy in front of me?
Yeah.
The one that came up to Ronnie?
Yep.
Hello, Ziv. Hello, Pally. These goblins are doing a little dance for us. You wanna play along?
Well, of course.
Oh, you're gonna...
Burning hands!
So, do you wanna get the one that is on the ground and, like, I'm standing menacingly over, or are you getting the guy who tried to slash at me with Captain America's shield?
The guy who ran over and tried to hit you with the shield.
Yeah, and
I just wrap my arms around his throat, burning hand.
So he succeeded the check, so it doesn't take as much damage.
Isn't it like half?
But oh boy, it's half. It's resistance is half. But he's in a lot of pain. There's clear chart. There's marks of just burns all up and down his neck. See a couple of third-degree burns mixed in there.
Noises, but it's kind of crackly because you got his neck.
Because of fire, yeah. He, however, does manage to break free of Antonio's hold. Is that all you want to do this turn? I don't think you can...
I'm not able to cast another spell.
Yeah, you're not. Okay. That'd be...
Okay, well... I want to, like, do the old one too again and, like, punch both these goblins in their throats.
So yes, in their throats.
First of all, the guy who I, not pinned, but threw on the ground, but the guy who got singed.
Alright, so, So the way you're going to want to do it, Ronnie, is if you go into your character sheet... Where it says fisticuffs, I'll try and keep that updated based on your guy on your level with everything, because it is, you're gonna have to keep looking back at the sheet to see when you need to up that to like D12, D16, D20, but for now,
so I'll just D6, click it then.
If you just click on it. You rolled a 23, Jesus Christ.
It's got a lot of modifiers.
That's one hit. Yeah, although I need to check, because it looks like Oh, man.
That was the first swing.
So where were we?
Oh, boy.
That was the one on the guy high floor with the 20 or whatever.
Yeah. You, this man is unconscious now. You hit him straight in the throat. He starts gasping for air. All right,
the second one with old 1-2, wasting him up, using up a moxie point.
I don't know what that second number is supposed to be.
I don't know what that second number is supposed to be. Oh, I think that's for advantage or something.
Oh yeah, that's probably what it is. Good point.
Yeah.
6+. Just watch the first
number. Oh boy.
Okay,
You knock them both on the ground. They have basically the same reaction. You get them both at the same time, and they just
okay. I got them both in their jugulars. We'll say punch zone, and they're both out.
Yeah, they're not quite dead, but they're pretty close to being okay. Dead.
And that's that. Now it's your turn. Wait,
yeah, they're unconscious.
No, Mason! Remember how I have shapes?
Shapes?
May I transform into my second shape, which happens to be a certain crocodilian-like creature?
I'm pretty sure you're able to. I haven't heavily looked over,
it's
but I'm pretty sure
it's weird.
Cast it.
The wild shape thing, actually. I can't click on it for some reason.
Let me see. I'm pretty sure the way it works is it takes the whole turn to do. Where's wild shape at? Oh, you have it in edit mode. That's why you can't. Here, let me... how do I take it out of this? Where is the... God, I'm not used to this sheet. Sorry about a lot of, like, the little...
It's fine. I have no idea edit mode. How to exactly use it correctly. Either.
There should be a button here. Somewhere that's, like, I'm done editing.
Oh, I have three moxie points. My bad. Didn't note that.
Grip tail, natural armor, lucky. Where'd you?
It's not under spells. It's actually on the front page, right here in core. If you go down, it's right above tongue lash. For some reason, wild shapes are strained to that.
Oh. I have no idea. I think that's the charges for it.
That's weird because it said there wasn't really any charges in the book.
For now, let's wait till I have more time to look over it with me moving things.
Alright, so just ignore transforming for now?
Yeah, we'll get back to that
okay.
Next session, hopefully, when I have time to pour over the books. Oh, poison spray.
Oh.
Nope.
Did I do that? What?
No, Bate.
Right on his face.
Oh, okay.
Ew.
It does one damage. So that wasn't poison so much as it was a very unpleasant
breath.
You
just forgot to brush your teeth, and you're like, and he's like,
Ronnie described it perfectly. He's like, ah, no! And like, it was so bad. Like, the little follicles that the text sent started dying.
And now, while he's distracted, can I do a dis? Oh crap, how do I roll? Base attack?
You should smack him with your shillelagh.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do, is smack him with my quarterstaff, but, well.
Let me look at Ronnie's and see if I can figure out why it's not. Oh, one second, I see where it is. I'm pretty sure.
Wow. Can I, like, call for the rat boy genius to come out here and, like, help us a bit? Not that we need it, but...
Okay, that's just bringing up the text of it. So should I just roll a d20?
Yeah. Roll for the normal attack. Do you not have a weapon?
For some reason, no.
Oh,
boy.
Doesn't that get the wisdom modifier, though?
I mean...
He's imbuing a weapon with it, so it'd be the weapon actually still has.
But the wisdom is the
roll. Oh, here, roll. Use the quarterstaff roll.
That's the quarters. Yeah.
Oh, the wisdom is the roll.
The wisdom's the modifier. And where's the quarterstaff roll at?
It's, if you go into your sheet, if you go to core, it's under.
Core under weapon. Why am I not seeing? What? Oh. Yeah.
Zottle, just Zottle. Core. And then there will be poison spray, quarterstaff, thorn. Why'd you put a bunch of your spells under weapons?
Just for ease of clicking it.
I'd prefer if you, when we, after this, you put them into spells.
Oh, wait, no, that's why. It's because it says attacks and spellcasting. Yeah.
Oh, really? That's wonky. You did hit him. Did one damage. Wait. Minus two. Yeah, you did one damage again. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait, wisdom becomes the modifier, right?
20. Wisdom, so it's 5. Modifier. Yeah, I rolled a nat 20, so I put it into wisdom.
Oh, shit. that's crazy. So, that goes from 1 damage to 9. You dent this man's helmet in, and a portion of his skull. And he's just dead.
His face is burned like acid. And like, you just poured a bunch of dish.
Yeah, he has shock wounds all over his body, he has a burnt face from acid, and he's just pummeled with a stick.
Cethus gets out of the car and goes, oh, pleasant.
I'm gonna say, it took you long enough, not that we needed it.
I'm gonna tell you guys not to kill these two unconscious guys.
Okay, I wanna grab both of these unconscious men, like,
I'm just
by their necks. And hold him up like fish trophies.
See, I have a plan, though. I can disguise self. I was gonna disguise myself to look like them, and then cast friends, and we're gonna figure out what their goblin lair is.
Okay, I'm gonna, like, grab both of these unconscious dudes by their necks a little tighter on the guy who got singed there and, like, toss him in the cart. Or, like, a backspace area or something.
But,
what are you gonna do?
I was gonna cast disguise self so I could look like a goblin and then act like a goblin, and you guys were gonna follow me back to the goblin lair.
Okay.
I just crawled
Mason,
back into
Mason,
the
Mason, how does the how's the environments looking? I need to like write some stuff down.
You guys are on a road in the
In the city. I thought we were.
You're towards the outer side, outskirts of the city, but you're still within city.
All right.
You still see occasionally some taller buildings, but there's a lot of smaller hovels and huts now, rather than massive towers.
Antonio, Ziv, or whatever your name was, do what you want. I'm gonna write some stuff down, and I.
You guys hide behind the character. They think that we killed you.
Cethus just kind of watching guys we're wrong.
I'm just sitting in the cart, just staring out at the scenery.
All right, I get back in the cart and like continue writing down,
if you would.
Scribbling, if you will.
So now that they're hidden, I'm gonna attack this guy self and look like one of the goblins.
Now we have a goblin on our side.
There you go.
Oh my god! This. So the problem is, as a dragonborn, you are, what, about 6 feet tall?
I can't remember how tall I am.
You're supposed to be like 5 to 6 feet tall. Goblins are about 3 feet tall. There's a good 1 to 2 foot difference.
Listen, I can make myself a foot smaller.
That's not gonna...
He's about a foot too tall. He's a very lanky goblin.
Just say you're a fur rogue and call it a day.
Here's the thing.
Be right back. I gotta use the restroom.
No, I also have friends, so I can get a bonus to charisma rolls.
Hey.
Alright.
Hey, Mason, is there anyone walking around on the street that just witnessed this little fiasco?
No, it's pretty dead.
Alright, I'm gonna wait till one of these fuckers wakes up.
Cethus just pulls out a pouch from his back pocket, reaches his hand in, and then his whole arm, and then, like, he opens it up a little bit and shoves his whole head in. And he from it, pulls out a tiny little vial and goes, and hands it to you and goes, make them drink this.
What is this exactly?
It'll wake him up.
Would I be able to cast Friends on them first before they wake up and it still helps them?
Friends is
the one. I get a bonus charisma checks.
Let me pop it open. Friends, bonus to charisma checks. Choice, creature cannot be hostile. Yeah, you'd be able to use it while they're asleep.
Okay, so I'm going to cast Friends on the... Probably not the one that I burned his throat. And I'm gonna...
Okay, I'm back.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and mark the one that you burned just so he... he's got the red circle on him. That's the one you burned.
Alright, so what's happened?
I wait for the one that I cast Friends on to wake up.
Did you make him drink the vial?
Yes.
He kind of just, like, starts writhing around. He rolls over on his face, pukes, stands up.
Yeah, I'm getting back in the cart.
Looks...
I'll leave you alone to this.
He looks really pissed off.
I tell him, hey, we got him. Don't worry. We just gotta get back.
Back to what? Oh.
Yo, Tool, or whatever your name is. You think what he's doing out there is ethical? I'm speaking to Anthony's character.
The goblin just looks at you and goes, oh! We did?
Yeah, we got him. It was one hell of a fight. I think me and you are the only ones left.
You see him looking around, he's like, I count.
She goes, ethical. One, two, three, no.
Oh.
Uncommon. Okay, no.
I'm gonna head to a doctor. You can go ahead and loot them. Make sure to stop by the bank for your pay.
I will. Thank you.
You remember where it is, right?
Sorry, it's on the mead. Could you remind me?
God damn it, you already got drunk. You're going to want to... So, find the... It's near the Savrani's Co... district.
It's Scrib, by the way.
If you walk into the Eastern Wing Bank, you'll be able to talk to him and just say, we did what Vert 2 wanted. And we'll be fine. You'll get paid 50 gold. It was supposed to be we only each get 10, but our pay just went up exponentially since your brother died.
Can I have a question?
All right.
Do I know where this the place is that he's talking about?
You do not.
Okay. So I'm gonna ask him how exactly did we get from here. I may have forgotten.
Well, your brother was your navigator. He just died.
He's dead.
If you hop in this carriage, you might want to be able to find the best way out of here. They didn't have a carriage operator before, so possibly you'll find more loot wherever they were supposed to be going.
Me. But I was kind of
more. All right. All right. So we're just stopped here on this road without a driver.
Cethus pops out and goes, all right, time's up. He pulls a crossbow out of his sleeve. Yes, he shoots in the right right in front and into the, at the ground at the goblin and just goes scram. The goblin runs away very quickly, yelling, "Oh shit!"
Did he get away?
Listen, we're on a tight schedule.
Thank you, Sithis. I was kind of getting uncomfortable.
The rest of the ride is pretty boring. Not much ends up happening. In fact, a lot of nothing ends up happening for the majority of the ride over. Let me just go ahead and make sure. For some reason, Antonio's character wasn't in the
Hold up. Thing. Hold up a second. Who's the dwarf?
That's Jake.
Oh, yeah, let's he's not supposed to be here right now.
Also, Mason, for that car ride, could you count me as meditating?
Yeah, okay. You all actually get your spells back. It was
so I get my moxie back, too?
Yeah. So as you all disembark, you notice that Cethys is suddenly a lot calmer. He isn't fiddling around with everything, and he's drinking tea with the most peaceful expression you think he could ever have on
his face. I make a remark. Comfortable not having eyes on your back?
No. Modus operandi.
You'll understand later. So, where was this guy that we were supposed to test? Or whatever you said.
He motions towards the gates and he goes,
"Alright, I step forward and
you
get ready."
Approach these giant metallic gates that creak extremely loud when you go to open them. And on the other side of the gates, I didn't have enough room to put like.
Those gates. I thought you were talking. Okay.
Yeah. I'll just put you guys there. Let's just leave Cephas there because it's easiest. And as you walk through, you notice a dwarf holding a noble upside down by his neck.
Wait.
And the noble is laughing.
Are we walking into something here?
See, this goes, oh god, that's...
Is that normal in this culture?
Yes, that's Lord Hoothwall. Him and Pebble have fun every time we have these get-togethers.
Have fun.
and the Lord, you see, manages to grab Pebble's arm and does a spring off and lands on his feet. And Pebble looks up and goes, "Oh, you're still hard as ever to defeat, Ulfthwall. I'll see you next time for our wrestling." Ulfthwall turns around and notices you all there. And your very confused expressions.
We were sent here by, Sithis.
Cethus says nothing and walks into the party and goes, but before he opens the doors, he goes, "That's the dwarf."
We were told about a dwarf we were supposed to meet here. Are you the man?
It seems like the only dwarf in the area.
Step up.
I step up.
All right. Ulfthwall moves to the side and goes, he looks at you and goes, "Are you the fresh meat?"
I guess that's what you could call a newcomer, sure.
Pebble just looks at you and says, "Hit me as hard as you can."
Just one punch or multiple?
One.
No response?
No, he looks at you and just goes, "I won."
Okay, I guess I'll try to just hit this guy in the chest without killing him.
That was a 24.
Ooh.
Oh. That wasn't supposed to happen. So, hit him for 6. You managed to a little bit of wind gets knocked out of him. He goes, aye, and starts clapping. He just goes, good, good. Maybe I can trust Cethus to pick out recruits after all.
I guess he goes, I'll head back in. Then.
Back up. Yes, you're welcome to go into the party. Mingle for a little bit.
Will do. Thanks for the test. And I walk in.
He then turns to Ziv and goes, you're magic, aren't you?
Indeed, I am.
Fire. Of course. Go ahead.
Got.
Just hit me with your standard riffraff spell.
I approach him. I grab his wrist. And I cast burning.
All right.
Nice day.
So, his wrists don't burn at all. He just looks up at you and goes, it was a little cold out, thanks. You two can head on into the party. I'll be out here kicking this old
man's
ass.
I'm confused. Mason, you cut out for me. At the very start of whatever. After it was warm out here.
Alright. He looks, he goes, aye, it was warm out here. And then he just goes and motions you guys to go to the party. And before you guys are able to get to the doors, he goes, if you need me, I'll be
here. He doesn't even bother to test me.
And him and Ulfthwal go back to their very eccentric wrestling and sparring. As you all walk in, Cethus looks over and goes, alright, you gotta know 2 things here. One, this is a political meeting like any other. You all are here because they want to feel safe. As of right now, there's no way an assassin could be here. We had some of our newer recruits, not as new as you men, but pretty new, come through and canvass the place for a whole week, and no one outside of the maids were here. Secondly,
all right.
The dining area is where all the lower nobles will be. Occasionally a fist fight or two will break out, if it does, ignore it. We're not here to mediate their disputes. If you want to talk to any of the more important nobility, which I believe we only have one of right now, the rest either declined to visit or did not see it important enough to come, they'll be upstairs.
What...
Generally, the lords will separate themselves like this at any party. It's a very important thing to know. The lower nobility, it's not seen as fashionable to be around.
Then I'll just stay out of it, then.
Isn't there a library?
I'll go into a corner and start, mapping out the place. Just for practice.
He, however, does turn you and go, the library upstairs has a very large collection of maps of the surrounding areas, both topographical and...
Oh, well,
cosmopolitan.
You know where I'll be. Okay.
As he's saying that, I just walk up.
So what kind of people are down there?
They look like
lower nobility. People who are trying to pass bills. They're very angry sorts.
They look like little jester.
Don't be afraid if a discussion devolves into who is closest in relation to the king. And try not to laugh at someone claiming that their 1,000th place in line is important.
Yep.
So the two
yes,
of you
we're
upstairs,
going to
right?
the library.
And Antonio, you go to mingle with the more interesting guests. Oh, wait, nope, turn order's not supposed to be.
I was getting kind of anxious there.
These are many stairs. Many, many stairs.
Yes. It's actually only a flight of stairs. It just seems exceptionally long. I wonder why.
Upstairs.
Upstairs. I couldn't find a better way to label it. So you are now up the stairs.
Is it a library?
Oh my god, did I...
We are in the void now.
It's okay, we don't really need a picture.
Yeah, I thought I did, but I guess not. Let me just, Let's get all... There we go. So, the walls are lined with just a ridiculous number of volumes of every kind. Give me a second. I'll keep describing it, but I need to put something down so I know where everything goes. And they seem to be rather disorganized. Whoever lived here last was a little... They weren't a big fan of the Dewey Decimal System, obviously.
Meh?
But the size of the collection is still quite...
Alright, I'm gonna go look for the map volumes and practice what I can.
May I search for cultural books?
Yes, you may.
That be an investigate roll, or is this just something I don't have to roll for?
Yeah, do an investigate roll, actually. I feel like that would be appropriate.
Boy.
See if you can find any specific books. Yep. 12? You find a couple of books, many talking about noble culture and about laws and regulations, and some about language that is deemed unparliamentary.
Excellent, I shall begin reading these and study.
The pages, the first page is labeled Fuddle-Duddle.
Gibberish. Excellent.
Upon further reading, you find out that a while ago, the Prime Minister was accused of mouthing the words fuck and off at one of his at one of the opposing parliamentary sides. When Art asked about it in an interview, he merely claimed he said the words fuddle-duddle as an insult. As a result, fuck you, fuck off, and fuddle-duddle have all been banned from use in the House of Commons and the House of Lords. Antonio, do you just walk in and try and join this party?
Do I find any, like, maps or anything in the library?
You find several. Many topographical maps, a couple that detail the layout of the city, but they seem extremely out of date, some being labeled from 100 years ago.
Alright, well, I'll just, like, take some notes on how they were made. Not, like, a big on what the areas are about or anything.
Alright. So, Antonio, you walking into the party, you hear the most common point of discussion is a bill that the lower nobility is trying to introduce. That the higher nobility has very little support for. Essentially, it would boil down to tougher regulations on the trade of manslaughter. And that assassins should not be freelance, but instead be state-owned and policed. And potentially removing the license to kill from certain investigative bodies. Many nobles are getting very heated about this, a couple shouting words that would be very unparliamentary at each other, and one deciding to yell, "Oi, your mom's a git and your brother's a fucking faggot." At this, two of the lower nobility begin sparring, and a crowd forms around them, cheering them on.
It just immediately battle.
Sorry, what happened? I had to go to the restroom real quickly.
Antonio is witnessing a bunch of noblemen turn into barbarians.
I'm gonna go into the crowd. I'm gonna walk as well. I'm just gonna enjoy this.
You notice a distinct lack of fists actually being thrown. There's several badly imitated wrestling moves being used. A lot of just pathetic left hooks being thrown. Nothing that would actually hurt someone.
Alright. I'm gonna get in between them and say, alright, this isn't even a real fight.
Antonio, get in between them and scream fuddle duddle.
Oh my god. No, you can't say that. He doesn't know about that yet.
So, the one that was insulted looks at you and goes, I am 198th in line to the throne. Who are you to tell me what to do?
198.
The other man goes, the 198th, I'm 50th in line, and attempts to throw a punch at Antonio. Out of just being, he just feels so insulted. You can, the look on his face is just aghast. He cannot believe that a mere mortal would get between him and his important discussion. And he punches, it hits your hide, and it does nothing.
Alright, are we hearing, like, the shouts and stuff from the library?
Yes, you are hearing a lot of shouting and commotion. And you think you hear a chair being tipped over?
Oh,
a chair.
Alright, I'll put the maps back and start heading downstairs.
Alright, so, as you all head downstairs...
I think Anthony was going to stay.
Yeah, I'm still reading all the different books.
You notice... Oh. So, Anthony, you notice in the corner of the library, there's a tiefling sitting with a book quite similar to what Ronnie's been reading.
Like, scroll maps?
It's covered in maps and... covered in maps and just very weird...
I'm going to keep one of my eyes on him while the other on my book.
So, Ronnie, you head downstairs?
I think you might be cutting out, Mason.
Do you head downstairs?
Anthony?
Oh, well.
Hi. Can you guys hear me?
I can hear you, Mason. You're cutty outy.
I can hear you now. It's kind of like cutting out. Yes, I do go downstairs.
Yeah, alright, so yeah. So you head downstairs, and you see Cethus is smoking a pipe, leaning against the door. And there is a giant circle of nobles shouting on two men that Antonio has stepped between, and one has his hand just sitting on the side of Antonio's face in a fist, and Vivico looks extremely upset.
Alright, I'm gonna walk over to Cethus, laughing, and ask what's going on.
A small spat.
I think you're cutting out again.
Yeah.
He leans forward and goes.
All right, I'll just walk up and watch it from the sidelines.
Hey Mason, do you think you could try Antonio's mic? Since yours keeps on cutting out.
No, because his is on his laptop, and
we could try it.
Well, see, the problem is I have a bunch of DM notes on
you
my.
You can't let Antonio see that.
If we're that. Yeah, it's all about.
You wanna just see if my mic will pick you up from here, though.
We can try.
Yeah, that was what I was thinking.
Here.
Hello, I'm going to be right back. I'm sorry.
Pick me up from over here.
I have some problem to take care of.
Yeah, I've been talking. Can they hear me?
I can barely hear him.
Ah shit.
I can increase my input.
Yeah, try and just up it. Hopefully,
I
when
also
I
also turn off push to talk.
Yeah, that would help.
Push to talk is off, and
all right, can they hear me?
If you guys have to.
It already is up.
Ronnie.
A lot.
Ronnie, can you hear me from him?
If he said something just then, no.
Yeah, no, it's not working. Damn.
Oh, shit. All right,
it was with the shot.
All right, we'll have to. It's probably because I'm using. An old, I left all my good
stuff
in the house. So, again, hopefully it's better next week. This week's kind of crazy. But, for now, let's just bear with it.
Yes, and
so, Ronnie,
I'm
you went downstairs,
watching the
right?
fight from the sidelines now.
So, Antonio, His fist is planted gently on the side of your face, with no real harm having come to you.
Yes. I moved his fist away from me, and I said, really, I told you not to test me. Do you really want to play these games?
He just goes, I apologize. And backs away, and they both kind of back away out of fear.
I tell them to go back to their little debate.
In which they do, quite loudly and heatedly. They all disperse and then go back to sitting around the table arguing about the random politics of the day.
Mason, is there any more books on the culture in the area that I have found?
You found another one that list that talked about how initially the rat folk took a lot of anger at the normal races inhabiting the land, trying to migrate into Deep Seal. However, over time, they've slowly been replaced more and more by humans and dwarves than they have been able to retain their heritage. To the point that the royal line has now begun to become more human than it is rat folk.
Alright, I'm gonna go over to the other side next to that tiefling and start looking through these maps.
Wait, I didn't see this tiefling or whoever when I was reading the maps. Okay.
Also, the books that I read, I'm gonna pocket.
All right. Make note that you pocketed the history of the 10th
age. Let me pull up my character sheet. So no, that would be notes.
You could also put it under equipment. They both weigh a pound.
So, 10.
So you
pocket history of the 10th age. Okay,
10th age. And you also pocketed unparliamentary language. The fuddle-duddle fiasco.
It's 1 pound, and then it's unparliamentary language fiasco.
Yep.
Okay. So, do I notice the room in the corner down here?
The one that's weirdly empty? Yes.
That's just empty?
Yep. Like, there's a lot of dust from where furniture used to be, but there's nothing there.
Alright, I'm gonna go to the restroom real quick.
I'm gonna ask the guy who punched me, I'm gonna ask him what's up with the room in the corner.
He just goes, oh, quite some time ago. That was used for the dance room, I think. This is an old hunting lodge that no one's been to in quite some time.
Dance room?
Yes. Previously, it was rather normal to have balls here. But due to the fact that the hunting lodge is quite tiny, it would always lead to cramped and, again, fights.
All right.
I apologize. I'm 40th in line to the throne. My brothers are quite stupid.
I walk up and I say, what's with this line to the throne? I heard like 4 people saying that during the fight.
Imagine it. You know how people will often argue about the size of their car.
I suppose I would. Oh, yes. So much, yes.
This is the noble debate version of it. Many people around here believe that because they are the lowest version of nobility, they're still above commoners. And they've gotten so accustomed to shouting it whenever a commoner tries to beg them for money, it's become just the regular thing to shout whenever a fight happens.
Oh, me too. When I start a fight, I shout that. Okay.
God damn it.
wait, hold on. I did not hear him at all. What did he say?
Well, I too shout how big my cock is when I get into a fight.
I'm gonna go into this dance room, and I'm gonna, like, investigate it.
Investigate the shit out of that shit.
Oh, you mean the room in the back left and not the room in the bottom right?
Yeah, I didn't.
Oh, the room. Oh, sorry. I thought you were talking about the one.
That's right, not a secret room. You can see that plain as day.
I didn't realize that. I didn't hear secret. The dude tells you that's the kitchen. So are you like
serious? I'm just taking a look for any Eastern jungle maps to see if they know of my homeland.
Wait, sorry. Antonio?
I'm looking for any food. I want food.
You see.
Okay, I'm going back to just writing down and maybe picking up a few scraps of food on the table. Whatever that is. That looks like watermelon.
What does a fella gotta do to get some of this turkey in here?
One of the nobles walks back. He walks up to you and just goes, that'll be distributed when the High Lords decide they want to participate.
How do I get them to participate? I'm pretty hungry.
I apologize. My grandma's calling me and I don't know.
The why. Noble's grandma?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
No, Mason just walked away.
Meanwhile, I'm looking for an Eastern jungle map and I'm about to talk to this tiefling. Oh boy.
Oh boy.
I'm out here trying to get turkey. Shut up, boy.
Antonio, you're fat. Shut up.
It's very mean.
I don't have to be nice. Especially near you savages.
Okay, this is a good time to ask about backgrounds. Where do you guys come from? Even though we're like an entire room and floor across.
I come from a village of dragons.
Like Skyrim?
Of course.
Are you from Skyrim?
Sorry about that.
No, I'm not from Skyrim.
the noble turns to you and goes, they'll participate when they're hungry, or whenever you can persuade them to head down. Uthwan's having too much fun outside beating up Pebble. However, when he smells the turkey,
speaking of, I'm gonna head in. Get a little bored and head outside to those guys and ask what they're doing, and I don't know.
They're still doing very. It's a mix of athleticism and wrestling. Every time one of them gets the other in a hold, they pull off.
All right, I just want to like ask if I can join them because like one of my skills is just fighting to pass time. What was it? Street?
Yeah.
Smart? Yeah.
It's yeah. You can spar
okay.
Pass time.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
So yeah, they. They welcome you in, but you can tell that they clearly they water it down a little bit so that you don't get
okay.
Too beat up. Oh yeah, by the way, Antonio, do you want hot chocolate Cliff Bar or gingerbread Cliff Bar?
Hot chocolate.
Fuck you.
So Mason?
Alright, yeah.
Also, I want
Mason. Did I find any maps on the Eastern jungles?
No, they were strangely nothing even talking about the East. It was all focused on Deep Seal and the...
Alright, I'm gonna ask this person a question. Are you the librarian? Or the...
Yeah, no.
The typhoon.
Yeah, him. He just goes, no.
Just no. Alright, well, that's all I need. I'm gonna go start looking through these maps.
He just looks up and goes, I'm just here to guard Lord Aporum.
I approach him and say, hello. How are you today, kind sir?
Quite good. You?
I'm doing pretty good. It's kind of boring here. Looking for something to do. I'm told to be on, like, a mission, but I don't exactly know what I'm doing
yet. As of right now, I'm pretty sure the entertainment later will be combat tests. For now, go find the lords and get them to stop fighting so we can eat.
So, where might I find these? Are these the ones downstairs?
He looks and goes, actually, as of right now, I believe my lord is the only one that needs to get off his lazy ass. He closes his book, stands up, and starts walking towards a little nook. He leans in and goes, Vaporum, hurry up. Are you following him?
Yeah.
All right. You notice that there is a single man in a purple embroidered robe sitting in front of a fire reading a book with his legs crossed. And upon hearing his tiefling yell at him, Vaporum looks back and goes, bite me.
Okay.
He just looks at you and goes, depends on how much gold you're offering.
So I don't have too much gold right now, but, I need a favor done.
What kind of favor?
I need you to go downstairs and eat with the
rest of them. Oh, shit, it's dinner time. I apologize. I've been too busy poring over books about this newest bill that's been passed.
Ooh, what bill, sir?
I'm a high advocate for the one that a lot of the lower nobility here today are arguing over. Restricting a lot of freedoms for the various guilds that specialize in making people disappear.
Well, I need to be able to do my duties, and the best way we can get that done is for everyone to meet.
He walks up. He starts heading out. Virtu follows next to her. The Tiefling follows next to him. And they head down into the dining area, where upon arriving, Vaporum, a glass and a small spoon appear in his hand, and he makes it ring out and goes, it's time for dinner. All the lords move a couple of inches away from the table and allow him...
Did we hear that while we were outside?
Oh, yeah. You definitely heard
it. All right. Loud. I head on in.
And Pebble walks in. Yes,
I'm going to stash the maps I took. Or pulled out.
I'm going to hide
you. Are you a freaking kleptomaniac or something?
No, I'm a librarian.
I'm a librarian. I'm a kleptomaniac. I'm a librarian with kleptomaniac.
I'd like to be aware of my surroundings, especially when I come from a place that has nothing similar. So what map did I grab? Mason?
A map of the 50-year-old city.
What was the full name?
A map of the city that is 50 years old.
You keep on cutting out for me.
Yeah, same here.
Just name it a 50-year-old map.
Does it weigh anything?
No.
Manap.
Shut up, Ronald!
50-year-old map. Okay.
Alright.
Alright, I wanna get some food. I'm fucking hungry, man.
I'm going to stay very recluse on my own some.
Alright, what's we got, boys? What are we eating?
You notice the only two that actually seem to sit down at the table with the chairs are the two High Lords present, Cethys and Pebble, and the bodyguard. The rest are just sitting around on the benches looking very nervous.
Oh, did I?
I whispered to the noble next to me.
Well, you see, it's standard procedure to let them pick their chair, to let the more important people pick their chairs, and then they decide if everyone else gets a seat.
Oh, I see.
Which the Tiefling leans back and goes, by the way, you're not going to be sitting on the benches
today. I get up and awkwardly shuffle over to a bench.
No, he, as you get up, he's like, no.
Oh, I shuffle over. Back to the table. So, what's going on? What's the grub today?
I just sit on the back behind, patiently.
You see a maid walk out of the kitchen holding a massive ensemble. There's turkey, there's a gigantic chicken. It looks like it just been poached and cooked about a couple minutes ago. Some very delicious smelling tea with a hint of spices and herbs in it. And a lot of booze on the plate. The platter itself probably weighs around 50 pounds. She comes and sets it on the table. I already have that set on the table. So, do you guys
just... Yeah, I start just, like, ripping into it.
Hello?
Hi. Sorry, I'm trying to...
Oh, that's fine. I was actually going to go grab my lunch because I haven't eaten anything.
Go ahead.
Oh, no, I just got it.
Alright, so, while you're all eating, the lights...
So these are electric lights?
Oh, wait, wrong button. Ha. No, they're candles.
Oh. Okay.
They
out. I'm kind of afraid for a sec, but I... Jesus Christ, my ears! I'm so sorry!
Hey, where's the background music? We gotta get something toony and cheery! Yes, something cheery!
It's gotta be, like, posh and something.
Yes, it has to be posh and cheery.
Oh my god. Here, I got this.
Oh, this is so... No.
That'll do. Alright, I continue eating, but, like, suspiciously.
The lights go out! You hear a massive...
I'm hungry, man! Because, yeah. No.
Yeah, that was the point. And the lights,
like, all the candles just relight.
And you notice.
Okay.
Yes. And there is, and now the noble at the head of the table has a massive knife sticking out of him.
With the man in purple.
Oh.
Yes.
Walk up to the corpse. I'm still and eating, by the way.
I didn't really notice anything, to be honest. Like, except for the big stab noise, because Jesus Christ, my ears.
Mason, is there anything I can infer about the blade?
Are you gonna, like,
I'm first gonna look at it, and then I'm going to try and take it out. Yep.
Alright, that was your perception check, right? Alright, so, it's a very well-made blade. It's very well-maintained. Looks like this thing would cost you a fortune at any well-respected forge.
Mm-hmm.
And it also seems to be secreting a very viscous liquid into...
So poison.
The Lord doesn't look quite dead. He's still moving his eyes around in fear, but he doesn't seem to be able to move his body.
Okay, so I should probably not remove it.
Okay, I look up for a second,
going
I say...
I'm do one last thing, and that is... I'm gonna roll another perception check to see if there's anything that could tell anyone made movement during the dark. You know, like footprints, or just... Actually, that would be investigation, wouldn't it? My bad.
Yeah. So the thing... Thing is, on top of that, all the nobles start just like, as soon as they see this, they jump back and, like, panic. A lot of them are starting to, like, try and walk away from the table and get just as far away as possible. One's almost...
Lock the doors.
Can I go around and investigate the room and see if there's any...
Okay,
Yes.
After all this happens, I finally look up from eating, and I'm like, what happened exactly? Because I figure the body's kind of obscured by the table's food and stuff. So I don't really see much.
Alright, so, Abate?
Yep, I investigated the knife and I investigated the floor.
So you notice a couple of things. Number one, the knife is pointed in a direction that makes it to where the little cone I drew is
about as what?
They had to be within that area. The cone that just appeared on, that should have just popped up, whoever threw it had to have been within that area. It's at a very weird angle, which means it wasn't thrown head on or from the right or from behind. You notice there's actually no footprints on the ground outside of, like, the nobles who backed up. They're all just kind of barren, I guess would be the best word.
The floor is just completely empty.
And it's also...
Also, for the noble who's almost at the door, I'm just going to give him a fair warning. Lock the doors. Or feel the wrath of Spiky Thor.
Yeah, he walks over, pulls the rapier off his side, and shoves it through the handles so no one can get out.
Perfect. We are now doing an investigation. Alright.
The Tiefling looks up and goes, oh. Fuck.
I'll leave you guys to it. If you need a map of the area, I have like a scribble drawn here, but that's about it.
The Tiefling stands on the table and proclaims, nobody move. The only three who are permitted to do anything right now are the three new recruits. Any who do will be dragged to hell by yours truly.
Who said that? The Tiefling? Okay.
I'm gonna go to this area.
Okay, I'll give Mr. Chameleon Man Tool, or whatever he said his name was, the really rough map I drew of the area, just like passively.
I'm gonna investigate near this area and like any exits.
Could I?
All right, so and then I'm going to go back to the table and start eating again.
So you happen to notice that there are footprints on top of the pool table. The vinyl lining has two dents.
Can I do a scent check?
Can I look, can I give a perception check to just, like, look around the table?
Yes, in fact, roll that, and Antonio, can you do
me?
An arcana check?
Me? Who's rolling?
Antonio. Antonio, and Ronnie, okay. Can you roll investigation?
Should I roll perception?
No. Ronnie, you don't really notice anything that hasn't already been pointed out other than the...
Okay, I continue. I just... I just continue eating. I'm...
Hold on. Mason, is the noble still alive? The one who has been stabbed? Or has he passed away?
From what he said,
His eyes seem to still be moving around, but his body seems to be entirely just stuck.
Should I try to do medicine?
Hold that. Antonio, so you rolled the Arcana, right?
Yeah, bad.
No, it wasn't. You got a 19. If I can find the thing. You notice there's a ritual circle. And on it, there's a glyph scryed. And it's a glyph of teleportation. You can read what the glyph prescribes.
Yeah, I'm gonna read that.
Alright, so it says that it will... Oh, fuck, let me pull up the note I have of it. That should be the easiest way to do it. Looks like I didn't make a note of it. That would be retarded. Did I seriously not make a note of it? I did not. Okay. I have to wait a little bit. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Can you guys still hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the ritual circle says that upon the circle no longer bearing any illumination, the user will be teleported 20 feet to the left and 15 feet to the south. 20 feet to the east and 15 feet to the south. There we
10
go.
Feet to the south. System. 10 feet. All right, Mason, can I do, like, is there any rule that I could tell what kind of liquid is on the blade?
Yes, all right. Be a normal investigation check.
I'm going to see if I can try and save the noble. Oh, there's my roll.
Save this regular old guy?
Yes.
I barely know.
So, you notice that that the blade is coated in a very special type of poison. It seems to not actually be killing him, but instead slowing his heart.
So I have to find a way to neutralize it. So any way that my medicine or nature skills could save him.
So here's the thing. The poison is also what's keeping him alive right now. The hole in his chest, it's gone.
Oh, so it's like one of those you can't remove it sorts of wounds.
That's, unless you had a cleric, it seems like there's no way
for you. Okay, so I'm going to recommend his bodyguard get a cleric.
We got a doctor in the house!
We won't be needing one.
I'm sorry,
his bodyguard looks up and goes, you won't be needing one. And, can you all roll a check, please?
Is that just wisdom?
No, there should be a thing that says perception.
Where? Oh, there it is.
In the character sheet. Yeah. So, only Antonio, you notice that everyone other than the three of you seem to not be moving at all. They seem to be frozen.
Oh!
Wait, who? Oh, only Antonio notices this? Okay, then I don't really need to.
Yes.
Have you frozen these nobles?
He just goes, that's quite an interesting question. What would make you ask me that there?
They just seem like dead frozen. They're not moving or doing anything at all.
Am I moving?
You are the investigators here.
Okay, yes, yeah, I'm still eating. I'm barely listening, to be honest.
You're just chowing down.
Yeah, seriously, like,
I'm hungry.
Do you know how long it took to get here? And that fight outside?
Shut up, exhausted skin.
Ronnie, you do happen to notice that Cethus next to you is frozen midway through trying to take a drink of tea, and it's just flowing down.
Okay, I chuckle a little bit. And I say, what the heck's wrong with you, man?
His eyes go from the calm that they were a couple seconds ago back to in every direction
what?
Possible.
What went from that?
Cethus. He went from looking calm and collected to...
Boy.
Okay, I finally stop eating and, like, look up and say...
I didn't hear you, Antonio.
Did you freeze these people? Was this something you've done, or...?
He just goes, well, your organization's quite the shitty bunch.
I don't know, they seem pretty jolly to me.
Let's just say, when I said there was... He looks at you and goes, let's just say when I said that there was going to be entertainment... I meant it. Oh my god, not the lower nobleman! Wrong person!
Is lower nobleman like a freaking wizard?
He's a very powerful nobleman! Being 150th does mean something!
John the farmer, conqueror of worlds!
He hits you with just a blast of energy that's just It looks like a giant black.
Where's
hole.
Wait, who was this?
Shit.
And it hits you for 8 damage. The type.
He weapon. Shot who?
Oh.
Antonio.
Amazing Grace.
Zing.
Our God has come.
Where's Bate's character at?
Should I?
Where's Ronnie's character?
This nigga's about to be in for a bad awakening.
Yes, everyone roll initiative.
Do I get to re-roll for initiative?
What?
Am I stuck with a 1 right now?
Yes. So Antonio, what'd you roll for initiative? 1
6
And Debate, what'd you roll? 6 and let me just okay, so that's a very high initiative right there. So upon shooting you with the blast, he then sprints up the stairs. And it looks like he's trying to get away. You also happen to hear a very loud noise from the earth. That sounds like rock suddenly jutting up from the ground. And a lot of metal bending and breaking and snapping.
Do you guys have any idea what just happened or what's going on?
Horned man evil, he betrayed like the rest of this filthy tribe, and now we have to go kill him.
All I understood was we have to go kill him, so let's go.
Also, can I make a nature roll for that rumbling sound?
Yes, go ahead.
Hey, clicked on it.
Well, it's pretty... you assume that your exit is now blocked by giant rocks.
Should I make one too?
And Antonio confirms it. Only if you think that your character would care enough to check to see what that rock
is. No, I have a different care. That's called immobilizing this fucker.
He just ran upstairs and were blocked by rocks or whatever?
No. There are no rocks on the inside. They appear to have all popped up on the inside around the perimeter. So it's Antonio's turn now.
My turn? Alright.
Avate, it wasn't your turn, you
fucking.
You can only move 30, I think. But yeah, you'd actually be able to make it to the stairs.
Only to the stairs?
Only to the stairs.
Can I fly up the stairs?
You don't have wings.
Wait, hold on. I want to go up the stairs.
You do? Yeah, but Ronnie. Combat just
but he got a 1.
He just got shot by demonic energy doohickeys.
Okay.
Give him a break.
Okay, I'll give him a break.
Yeah, I'm because he's the one that got hit. I'm.
I mean, doesn't he deal double damage? Shouldn't he be dead right now? Surprise attack. Teehee.
No magic. It's a thing that takes a full turn to cast. So. I don't think it's much of a surprise if it also requires the verbal component and light up around him when he's casting it.
So he's a massive faggot. Got it.
Yes. Alright, so Antonio, you run to the upstairs?
Yeah.
Alright, so can you just put yourself into the upstairs area? What? Did it? What? What's it doing right now?
Weird shit.
Alright.
Okay, I'm here.
Alright, put yourself, like, right on the stairs.
It also isn't, like, where my mouse actually is. The cursor's off. It's weird.
That sounds really weird.
Okay.
So, He's about 45 feet away from you, standing in front of a door, when he turns around and just sees you, and he's kind of panicking a little bit.
Am I allowed to cast a spell now?
Yeah.
I'm gonna do Witch Bolt. Bam!
You're gonna cast Witch Bolt?
Yeah. Bam!
Oh, how much damage is that? 1d12. All right, did you use a higher level spell slot to cast it?
Yes.
All right, can you roll a d12? Actually, I got that, sorry.
Oh, thank God. I got a one.
And then you get another one, right, because you used a second level spell slot?
Yep.
9, so 10 damage. And that makes it...
I'm doing the same thing as Antonio, rushing up the stairs.
Hold up, I need to adjust my ability scores.
Yep.
Alright, now that I'm up the stairs, I'm going to use my ability. My special power! Which means he's getting up close and personal now.
What is it? What are you casting? Thorn Whip? You rolled a 1.
I rolled a 1? Aw, shit.
Yeah, you miss, and you actually knock the door in front of him open.
Oh. Oops. Well, that's an unfortunate turn of events.
Whoops, sorry about that.
Not sorry. No, more like, can I exert myself to make a little bit of an extra burst just because I fucked up there in a panic?
No.
Like, you know.
Ronnie's turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna follow everybody upstairs.
Yeah, you're fine to
do. Should I, like, use a moxie point to dash upstairs? Okay, I just run upstairs and I am upstairs.
Yep, but you don't really have any more
damage. I could use a moxie point to dash.
The one place where turning into a feline would be useful.
But that only doubles your movement range, right?
I think, yeah.
Yeah, you
just okay, then I'll stay upstairs and watch what everybody else is doing.
Alright, so before he runs in the door, he turns around and shouts, "I will drag all of you to hell." And so the squares that just popped up, those are giant walls of fire that are just engulfing the upstairs. And if I can just grab this one and token layer. And there's a very particularly intense one in front of the door. And if I and he slams the door shut and attempts to, and you hear like a lot of just movement in the room. And that'd be the end of his turn.
Whose turn is it now?
Antonio's.
No, the way downstairs is actually...
Hey, Mason, can you adjust... Yeah. Can you adjust the other two or three character sheets so that we can see them but not edit them? Because...
Can you guys edit each other's character sheets?
No. That's a no.
Wait, what do you mean?
Like, there's a...
He wants to see the other party members' character sheets.
Yeah, you can see other people's character sheets, but... Like, you can't edit them. There's an option for that somewhere.
I would prefer not
do that real fast.
To do that, though.
It's just so that I can see your guys' names on the, like, initiative order.
Oh, is it not showing your guys' names? Oh, no, that's... Abate's isn't showing because his, for some reason, isn't marked as his character. I'll have to fix that.
What did Antonio do, by the way? Because we couldn't hear him.
Antonio, have you made it?
I'm gonna move downstairs, and I'm gonna find. My goal is to try to get him out of his little trance and ask him for another way out.
You see him? He's actually standing up, looking around the table, like, "Oh shit, we did not see this coming."
Hmm.
He turns around and he goes, there's an old crawl space upstairs in one of the bedrooms. It leads down to a wine cellar. But other than that, I don't think so.
Most of the upstairs is consumed with fire.
I'm gonna have to figure out who was supposed to sweep the place for magical runes, and I'm gonna have to fire them on the spot. You all need to worry about chasing him. I'll make sure no one down here dies, including the great lord.
Idea. Idea, Mason. Do you think I can spray enough poison to get through the first part of the hellfire?
Oh my god. It's a magical fire. So you can
attempt it, yeah. Oh boy.
Poison's the fire, it goes down and then it pops right back up.
Okay, so I have a short time window, don't I? Well,
it's like fractions of a second before the fire pops back
up. In other words, no.
However, the fire
doesn't go up to the previous point.
No, exactly. No, the fire is only about the height of a human. It doesn't go up to the ceiling.
Okay. I know what to do now.
Fly over it.
I'm going to go over to this little section-y here. I'm going to crawl onto the ceiling.
Yep, go ahead. You don't need to roll an athletics.
Good luck with the smoke. Hands and feet.
I will be fine. I can probably hold my breath through it. I am not a human.
You're just
gonna try and crawl over, get past the first section and see, drop down and see what's the problem.
Oh, there's the entire upstairs that you can see has been in.
Okay. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna crawl over to the door.
You're only gonna crawl about 30
feet. Yep.
I'm pretty sure that's your movement range. Alright, Squib's turn.
And
so I just witnessed
the door is covered in hellfire.
Yes, the door seems to be covered in hellfire.
Hmm. Okay.
So Ronnie, you did just witness him walk over to a wall and then start crawling along the ceiling above the fires.
So, I can't really do much here, so I guess I'll just head downstairs and see if I can get something to douse the fires. Like any drink or something that we were having. What was the drink I was having, by the way?
Alright.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah,
go get that.
I'll go use the tea. The British fire extinguisher. That's not the right button. Whoops. Alright, that makes
sense. Wait, hold on. I was going downstairs to get tea, remember?
Oh. Oh, yeah, are you... I don't know if you have enough movement to actually... Because from the stairs, it'd be 30 feet to the table. So yeah, you do.
Okay, so I'm at the table and grab it.
In fact, let me just go ahead and...
Okay, I have a... Is it like a pitcher full of tea, or...?
It is a massive...
Okay, I'll add that made for to my inventory.
In fact, I'll just go ahead and transfer it over...
Where's my inventory?
It should be under equipment, is what it's usually under.
We're gonna have to finish this up soon.
Yeah, I'm thinking... Because does my mom want us done by 5 or something?
No, I want to talk to my mom before it's late.
Yeah, 5:36 will be the cutoff. So, that now makes it Antonio's turn.
Yeah, I move upstairs, and I'm going to try to fly over this first wall of fire over here. Right, move here, and see what's above me, since that's all dark.
So... One second, it didn't do what it was supposed to earlier. Shisa. Why is this being such a pain? Alright, can I select this? No, it's not letting me select it. Alright, sorry about that. So, you notice, actually, that the wall of fire seems to extend, and it's not letting me actually edit it, so it's fucking, there we go. The wall of fire that's blocking the way in to the room seems to extend only up to this door. And it stops at the cutoff.
Gotcha. Well, I'm going to fly up close here. And move towards this area.
Alright, so I think that's as much as you're going to be able to move this turn.
Yep.
Which
okay.
Albates.
Plan number one.
Roll constitution check. To see if you survived the smoke.
Shit, Abata Antonio did beat me to it. Roll constitution check.
Are you sure I can't hold my breath?
It's longer than one turn. I think a turn's like, what, 5-10 seconds? Well, it's plausible. I don't think you're gonna hold your breath for that long while crawling on the ceiling and holding your body up. You cough a little bit, but it's nothing that's gonna cause you to lose your grip on the...
And below me is just straight up flames.
Yes, Antonio did find the one area that's only just a wall instead of a filled-in.
Wait, so hold on. Below me, is there like just there's like a spot I can drop down to, right?
Antonio is so. I'm just gonna go ahead and just like give you. So that area is covered.
That area is, and where Antonio is.
There's like, yeah, the fire kind of has.
Okay, so step number one: not fall into the flames. So, then drop down, and, is there a, flame wall against the door, or is it just not there?
Nope, that door is not blocked. Abate, are you gonna do the sprint thing, or, because you moved...
There? Okay.
Right about there.
Alright, then that's fine.
It's only 30.
I still have idea.
Alright, Scrib.
What? Oh, Scrib? Money. Me?
Mm-hmm.
I go upstairs with that big ol' kettle of tea. Wait, no.
Alright.
I remember what he did with the poison, and I look around the table first.
Okay. What are you looking... Just roll an investigation check, then. Six? You don't really find much.
That's it? Okay, head up with the big old kettle of tea, then. And, okay, I try to douse the flames with it, if I'm close enough to it.
Bonnie just throws the kettle across the room. Die, no, fire!
I just gotta extinguish the flames, man. It's a big hazard.
Tactical anti-fire grenade out!
I can't just walk right into it.
So, Ronnie?
Howdy.
Yeah, I doused the flames with tea. All
right. So you... Yeah, you actually do manage to create an opening. About...
Okay.
You're not going to be able to take it this turn, but it seems that you've managed to actually douse a good section
of the fire tea on it.
So that makes it Antonio's turn. You're gonna so burst into the room.
Yeah. I'm gonna look around. See what else I can see.
Two beds, there's a door.
Can I do the perception check to see if there's a trap door in here?
Yeah, you can.
Is that perception or investigation?
Investigation. So you don't notice a trapdoor, but you do hear a draft. You do feel a draft coming from the outside, from the wall right here.
I can't move anymore.
So you're just like, shit, there's a draft.
Close the window, it's cold.
So now it's Bate's turn.
Draft is smaft, friends. Okay. So I just walk up, I look outside, I look to the back of the room, right. And what do I see?
Like you
just this area that's like completely pitch black for some reason.
I was gonna say, did I forget to reveal that area? I did, I apologize. Yeah, that's just the wall. So like, are you just gonna...
No, I'm not like staring it down, I'm just looking there like, Alright, I'm gonna look at the side wall.
Roll perception for
the what?
Perception twice.
For what?
Roll perception. Are you?
I just looked at the back wall. Trying to like, yeah, just to see, like, suspicious. Then I'm actually checking the side wall. I want to see how thick it is.
So the bat. How are you gonna test how thick it is? Are you gonna like tap it and be like? Or are you just gonna try and guess it off of,
It is wood, is it not?
By looking at it.
Nature.
Yes.
But no. I'm actually just gonna try and, tap it to see if any sound projects backwards or if it's just gonna be absorbed through.
Alright, you tap it, and, we don't have any music, that's not the right one. I just now realized that was supposed to be playing this whole time. Whoops. The wall is hollow. It's pretty much... You also know it
can... So it's hollow. Bearing. Okay!
Yep.
Let's see if I can step back. So, right
I'm sorry, that was not supposed to be that loud.
I think, like, 15. That's 10. Yeah, I can step back. Okay. Uh-oh.
All right.
So yeah, I step back from the wall. All
right.
I'm going to break through the wall.
Oh my god, you threw fire on a wooden wall. Why?
Don't you guys have
fire? That's
don't you guys have limited magic?
I haven't used that one yet, though.
Yes.
And I'm gonna blow up a hole through the wall.
Isn't it based on the level used, though?
Alright, Abate, you do manage to put a little hole, not enough for you to get through, but
perfect.
You can see into the next room.
And what is in that room? Perfect.
It's pretty empty.
We have a start. We're gonna break through and kill that fucker. And is that my turn?
Yep, so I'd make it Ronnie's. Alright, Ronnie, your turn.
I didn't hear you say it. Is the tea, like, puddle expanding?
Yes, it is getting slightly bigger. Selected. Wow, Wolfman is not like me trying to...
Antonio has no input on a fireball being shot past his head into a wall.
No,
fire
mage, I don't get it. I breathe fire.
So yeah, Ronnie, there's
okay,
a big wall for you to get through now.
To where?
I just wasn't gonna be the idiot who shot.
Is it just this blue area here?
Yeah. The blue area and then the entirety of the area right here.
How do you do the wave click or whatever?
Click. Just holding click.
What? I couldn't.
If you just left click.
I'm not seeing it.
If you have to have the select move. And if you just hold down left click, it should pop up.
It's not popping up. I'll just run along whatever corridor I can to where they were heading.
Alright, yeah. If you want to make it there, you'd have to use
Okay, then, yeah, I Moxie, break in, and... Ask what they're doing when
Human
I get...
punch hole through wall!
Wait, hold on,
what the fuck?
Is there still a giant, like, wall of fire with that giant...
No, the wall of fire did not expand.
Okay. Then, yeah, I'll just head in here where they're messing around and ask what's going on, and we already did that.
Yep, in short, Abate want hole in wall, Antonio wants...
I want to investigate... Wall. Well, actually, I'm gonna ask Abate, like, what are you doing?
Breaking through.
Okay, I'm going to ask, where are we breaking through?
I point at the wall that I shot a fireball through.
Okay, I'm going to ram this wall as hard as I can. Is it like a solid wall?
No, it's okay. Hollow. They found out it was hollow. Roll a strength check. I'll give you the advantage because it's wooden. You run in, and you put a giant dent in it. And because of the fireball that was slowly charring the wall anyway, it breaks down. And actually, I think I can do something... And the wall crumbles.
Oh, all right. What do we see inside? What's in the egg?
There's another bedroom. And you see there's another bedroom on the... there's another wall, far wall. However, you notice that the draft in this room is a bit stronger.
Can I do an investigation check of this place? Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Super is drafty in here, fellas.
Your response is, did anyone see the chickens?
Hey guys, it's really warm in here. Man, whoever built this place knows how to do some really good insulation.
Antonio. You conclude that there is indeed a wall there. Antonio, you did an investigation check?
I investigated the shit out of that draft.
Alright.
Any draft, ain't you ask me.
So, you know, trying to remember what that type of wood's called. The wood where you can see the...
Mahogany!
...trees still... I mean, no, I don't think that's actually what it is, but sure. As you're feeling around, you hit where one of the tree rings is, and it slides back like a button, and you hear some wood slam open nearby.
Oh shit, my perception, where
at? Yes, go ahead and roll a perception. You guess it came from around here.
Well, time to go hole in this hole. Alright, you ready for what I'm about to do?
Oh, yeah, actually, it's still Antonio's turn. Go ahead, what are you doing?
I'm gonna come right here, and I'm gonna
breathe. What's he doing? The wall. Cut out for me.
More fire!
I'm breathing fire. I actually don't know how much damage that does, so...
Yeah, cast something that has a bit of explosive force.
He's a fire mage.
What is it with you guys and, like, spells on everything you come across?
I am a druid. I cannot turn into creatures yet. Therefore, I use my other option.
I'm gonna scorching ray the wall.
What are you doing?
Scorching ray.
Oh, god damn. Go ahead, yep.
Three beams of fire.
Ignoring the fact that, for some reason, that put through. You burn a giant circular hole in the wall, big enough for all of you to walk through. And you notice that, if I can... So pretend that there is a hatch, or there's an opening right there. Let me just go ahead and also draw in the... passage. Yeah, there's a hatch right there. Alright,
Alright, how much more do I have? I have, okay. So... yeah, I'm just moving up.
Alright. You can sprint, and that... but you won't be
attack?
Able to...
attack? I'm sorry, what did you say, Mason?
Yeah. So, you can sprint, which will double
your... Oh, if that's the case, then yes, I will sprint.
Alright.
Yep.
Are you just sprint over to the hatch?
So... 15. Alright, do I see anything?
One second, let me just put the hatch down. Oh my god, why are there so many metallic hatches? I thought I had everything, like, it's all been planned out, it's just, Christ. So ignore the fact that
it's like
this. It's a fallout shelter.
I've been hit by a hatch!
It's not supposed to. I've been hit by a hatch! But, you look down, and you can see there's a pretty big ladder, and at the bottom, there seems to be a really stone
circle. I was hoping you were gonna say fucking Tiefling, because I would have hopped down that ladder in half a second. I guess I should start climbing down, shouldn't I?
I think you're out of
movement. Sorry, what? No, I only used 15 to get over here.
Oh, you only used
15? Yeah, but I sprinted.
To get over to here, and then you had to stop, and then you sprinted, which doubles it, so you have...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I said. I'm climbing down the ladder.
Alright.
I wouldn't suggest it, considering you can't...
Nah, I'll be fine.
Wait, nope. So, you make it to the bottom of the ladder. And you see standing right there. Oh, he's not. Oh, god.
Yay! I keep hitting the wrong. I see the cage.
You see Virtu just standing there, and he's just really confused as to how you got to him.
I'm not even gonna say a word. I'm just gonna stare at him.
But fire!
No, I'm not gonna say anything. I'm just gonna stare at him.
Alright, so...
I'll run over wherever I... like, closest I can to that big circular...
What? Ryan just cut out? I think.
Yeah, well, I think Ryan just cut out. I think we need to get our mic situation situated.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot of problems we can fix.
We said we were gonna get it fixed when, like, move.
What?
Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that.
Oh.
Yeah, I was, like, running as far as I can, like, through the scorched hole in the wall or whatever. Like, mm-hmm. Like,
are you gonna?
Yeah, I'm going down the hatch.
Down the hatch. Down the hatch with you, you filthy whelp.
Okay. Is that it? That's all?
Mm-hmm.
That's all my movement options? Yep. Can I, like, run forward and punch this guy or anything?
You should have enough to run up and punch him.
I have enough to run up and punch him, you said? Okay, I want to, I just want to, like, grapple this guy. I want to fucking hold him like I would a hostage.
You're gonna run up and try and put this man in a lock? I think you just roll. I think it's a strength check, if I remember right. Wait, no. Oh, Christ.
Don't I get? Yeah, like I get big advantages for that stuff for doing the whatever fighting class I had.
Yeah, one second. I'm trying to find the quick reference thing. Alright. So I need to put this in. So
it'll be like a...
It's a strength... It's an athletic check by your opponent's acrobatics. So you do an athletics check. And it'd be his athletic. Oh god, okay,
I got this guy in like a headlock. Okay.
Yes.
He's all yours, I say.
Oh my god, you put yourself to the left and yeah. So he's just kind of squirming trying to get out. However, you notice that suddenly, his body's covered in spikes.
Ouchie.
And, yes, lots of pain. You take 6 damage. From his thrashing about, it causes the spikes to go in and out of your body, and they're very sharp.
Another moxie point I can do, temporary hit points for brace up.
I don't think you'd be able to cast that because you already used your extra thing to dash.
It's just another bonus action, and I just got to use a moxie point for it. I have 2 left.
Yeah, but doesn't brace up like you cross your arms and? Let me make sure. Actually, yeah, you could totally do that while putting someone in a neck. So yeah, brace up. You would.
I think it might be another one I'm referring to. Like,
that's one that gives you temporary HP, right? So roll 1d6 plus.
No, it was Dig Deep that I was looking for. As a bonus action, you gain resistance to bludgeoning, piercing, and slashing. So, I use Dig Deep when I grapple him. Okay.
3 damage.
And that's also an extra moxie point. So I got 3...
Yep.
Back. Can I use old one too to like punch him for another bonus action? Or no?
You only get one, I'm pretty sure, but I'm allowing brace up because it made okay. It dig deep because it made sense. Since it's not actually an attack, it's just okay. Kind of like, I'm ready. Antonio, your turn. What? Bernie.
He's a demon!
I don't want him to move.
Yeah, he's a
demon, though.
So?
You know what? Let him do it. Let him do it. I support this action.
What kind of save is it? It's a dex save. DC 12. Dex save 13. Well, it would actually be at a disadvantage because he's...
Mm-hmm.
Got him in headlock.
Yeah, 9 damage.
Yay. I burnt this bucket. Remember he took 9 damage earlier from
Witchbolt. Okay. I know. So let's see. Let's do this right this time. Because I don't think we did it right last time.
What are you doing?
Please don't cast an AoE.
No, I'm not spellcasting an AoE. You don't know what I'm casting, dumbass.
Please don't cast an AoE while I'm grabbing him.
And you haven't done anything but AoE.
I can barely hear Antonio. Or Ron.
Alright, just...
Can you hear me?
What are you casting? Oh my god.
However,
alright.
Am I reading this correctly when it says I can use my spellcasting ability roll instead of my strength roll?
Yeah, that means that the actual two, like, the damage modifier isn't strength, it'd be wisdom.
Okay, so I could use wisdom instead of a strength for my stat.
It does use wisdom instead of strength when you cast that.
Okay.
Instead of it being an option.
Well.
Lucky.
It was with advantage because he was grappled, right?
So is the right advantage or disadvantage?
Advantage, because I'm grappling him, right?
Yeah, what, Antonio?
Do you have any, like, generic allergy medicine?
Because
cats and fur make my allergies have seizures and my allergies.
Antonio's Mason? Got the sniffles.
Mason? Lucky.
Yeah?
Lucky.
Lucky?
I can't click on it.
Oh, yeah, go ahead. Yeah, you just you have it set.
Oh, okay.
Anthony, he is grappled, so I think you got the advantage.
Oh, no, you have to click on the little... There you go. Oh, that's not for Virtu, that's for Abate.
There we go. Alright, so let's do this again. It still says I'm using strength for my quarterstaff, which is bothering me a little bit.
Yeah, I know what it should be. Since you have a +5, I can fix
okay.
Levels. So just roll again. That's only a 10 to hit, though.
But what about the grapple?
Even with the disadvantage and the +5 from my wisdom roll?
Yeah,
even with the grapple?
His armor class. Yeah, his armor class isn't super low. Yeah, even with
like,
the grapple.
When he rolled the 17 before, does he get that for advantage?
No, he didn't. I don't know what the right roll is. I want to say it'd be advantage, but at the same time, it seems to be pretty inconsistent. I'll check later. But for now, let's just kind of ignore it, because it seems like it's inconsistent. Oh, yeah, it's his turn now. So, the barbs that were covering his skin... shoot out.
Again?
Uh-huh. And it's not... And it Well, they don't shoot. Well, they actually fire out this time instead of just being not retracting, but popping up on his body. They actually shoot out. And all of you take 3 damage.
Would that be like 1 or 2 points of damage for me because of the iron chin or whatever? Okay.
There's no way to dodge it.
Nope. You're in such close quarters that it's just. And that was his bonus action. He's going to. Let me make sure I check the quick reference. It's going to be a strength. So he's going to attempt to escape the grapple.
If he tries to escape and prevails, I think I have a skill that makes him have to.
Does he get any disadvantage for me, like, burning his ankles?
No, because it wasn't a massive burn, it was, like, a singe or a, like, burst. It's nothing that'll stop them from working.
Check the compression lock there, if he succeeded that.
Yeah, he did succeed. You're gonna have to actually before we do that, you need to roll athletics. Ronnie? Athletics should be like 4th from the top.
Oh, you want me to make an athletics? Okay.
Yeah, you have to roll athletics. Because it's a check versus a check to see if he gets out. Or, yeah, so he goes to get out, but the compression lock kicks in. 16 versus 12. He does escape. And as he escapes, he pulls out another dagger from his side. And he goes for a stab on Ronnie. What's your armor class, Ronnie? It should be 14, right? Oh, yeah. He goes to stab you, but he doesn't get quite the right angle, and it's a superficial wound and doesn't even seem to hurt at all. So, Ronnie, it's your turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna start railing this guy in the face. Railing him in the face. So, that's on our.
Yeah, fisticuffs. More than one punch or just one punch?
I'll do that, and then I'll use a moxie point to try to grapple him again. Because that's still part of groundwork, I think.
Let me see.
It's to the mat, like near the bottom.
Yeah. He manages to parry your punch with his quarterstaff. However, can you roll for the
athletics?
Yep. He manages to deflect your grab with his staff and just like shoves you.
Hey, what?
The rest of your party.
Okay.
You didn't get the grab. And he shoves you into a bot.
Alright.
All right, so I'll make it Antonio's turn.
I have a question.
Yes?
What is the staff made of?
It looks like it's a standard wooden staff.
Wooden, that's boring as shit. I'm gonna
shock and grasp his fucking ankle. You're still. Dragonborn's just holding on to his ankles. I'm gonna get you one day! 23. Jesus Christ. Shocking Grasp plus 4. Actually, you click on the. You see where it says touch and the Shocking Grasp? Click on that, please.
Wait, where is it?
It should be in the chat log. Like, right under the rolls, it says, like, Shocking Grasp and then plus. Should be a plus 4. So, that's 6 damage. You can, so he doesn't visibly spaz out from it, but you can see his leg, like, you can feel the muscles start to freak out and extract, or retract and expand rapidly.
I'm just gonna shove Ronnie aside for 1 second. Okay, so Antonio just grabbed his ankles and shocked him, right? Right, Mason?
Yes. Yes.
That's what did we say about AoE and a tiny robot?
Don't worry, you're not in the way this time.
Oh, what's that? We're in a stone cellar? I know. Let's do Thunder Wave. For frick's sake.
Well, there's been weirder spells cast.
I mean, it's not gonna travel in stone.
Yeah, like the one you cast on Becca last night.
Alright, so it's a DC 15. Where is... There he is. 15 against what? Constitution save. Is it... Oh. He flies against the wall.
I'm sorry, what? What damage?
And since he...
This cutting out is actually extremely fucking with me.
Yeah, it hit. He went flying into the wall behind him. And it dealt 13 damage, so. Alright, so that would make it his turn now.
You guys are keeping track of how many spells you're using,
so,
right?
Yeah. How much damage did I do to him? 13. Oh.
13.
Okay. And now he's against the wall.
Yep. Is this the spell I'm thinking of? Let me check. I gotta make some. Alright, so he stands up after being thrown into the wall and casts Arms of Hadar. He puts his hands, like, in front of him, and a massive wall of black energy appears in front of him. And tentacles and tendrils shoot out and hit...
Oh, God, that's kind
of God damn it. And hit all of you.
Oh, by the way, how much damage did that dagger from before do, Mason?
It didn't.
It just wasn't anything? Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't anything. So, if you all could do a... Where is it? A strength
saving throw.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, yay. That's good for me, right? Right.
What is... I gotta check. Because it's... I'm just gonna keep his in a pop-out window because... Going back and forth is not fun. His magic should... Where is it? Spells. You all take 5 damage.
My strength save wasn't high enough.
And our... It was not high enough. Oh, you all have minus
2.
So I just got all my moxie points back. Again.
Mason.
Yeah, go ahead.
Mason?
Go ahead and reroll it.
I'm sorry, you keep on cutting out on me! Well. Fuck.
8 minus... Alright, you all take 5 damage. And are rooted in place. He also, because he has other spells that I forgot existed, cast Poison Spray. So, is Poison Spray... I don't remember. Is it a cone or a line? Alright, he shoots the Poison Spray at...
Who?
Ronnie.
Scrib?
Ronnie, can you do a
Constitution?
Yeah, he Oh, you succeed. Is it on a failed roll? You take no damage? Yeah, you take no damage. Okay. That's nifty. We should make it Scrib's turn. It smells like someone shot a fart at me.
Okay, I'm just gonna start going all ham on this guy. Not really grappling him anymore, just like straight up punching him. Am I restrained by anything, like you said before?
You are rooted in place, but I think you might have a thing that lets you get out of
it. I don't know.
Let me make sure, because it might have just been, can't take reaction. Oh, never mind, you're able to move. You just can't, do area
attacks. Okay, so how many, like, bonus actions can I do in one turn?
Should only be one. Quick reference.
I want to use up all of my moxie points to rail this guy in the face all the times I can. I'm going to punch him, and then I'm going to 1-2 punch him, and then I'm going to 1-3 punch him, and then I'm going to 1-4 punch him.
I will.
Okay.
Wait, does it say that that counts
yes,
as a bonus action?
1-2 punch, Kent says a bonus action, it says.
I think, yeah, I'm pretty sure you only get one per turn, so you're not going to do a 1-2.
Okay, so that's two fisticuffs rolls?
Yep. 19, yeah, that's a hit. And so you get one hit. Oh, can you hit it just because I don't want to be the one rolling for you guys? Or actually, I'll go ahead and let you guys take that 10, but from now on, you see where it says
fisticuffs?
You used? Yeah, if you click on that, it'll roll for
Oh, bludgeon. Oh, okay.
Yeah. So you did. Just gave him a nice little punch in the face. The other one, so you went for a right hook, and he uses his staff to deflect it. But you didn't see the left hook coming in that knocked him right up under the chin and just pain. You also see a couple of the barbs on his skin go flying up after you finish the punch.
So it's like one of those things you see in the action animations where you see sweat flying off of them, but it's like spikes. Alright.
Yeah.
Also, I want to use my turn to like look around a bit.
You're in a very
what's a vase on the floor
cellar.
Or whatever?
That's the tea.
I was still carrying it? I thought I left it on the floor. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
I thought you.
Okay, it's just a stone cellar. Nothing about that little bench there.
That's actually another hatch that leads out, that you assume leads out. And there is a stone cage, or not, a metal cage in the room. It's right. If I can ping it. There we go.
Is it my turn?
Yes, it is your turn.
I'm gonna look at this nick and you know what I'm gonna do? Bam.
How many spells do you guys have?
A lot. That's his racial trait.
He's a dragonborn, and that's...
I had to go look up what it does in the textbook.
So... It's 2d6.
Yeah.
And the save. The save roll. Let me. What saving roll is it?
It'd be a fire resistance, I think.
So I'm gonna say for now. I'm gonna say it's Constitution.
Yay.
He takes 2d6. Can you click on it where it says breath weapon and just roll it?
Where at?
You see where you made the actual roll and then the little text on it that says breath? There we go. 7 fire. He has resistance, so it's... He chucks it off pretty easily. It doesn't seem like it does much to him. You are a fire lizard, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
Oh boy.
Abate's turn.
So Mason, remember how I have this?
Yes.
Mason? So you know how Ronnie knocked off a couple of the spikes? I'm gonna try and pull him onto his face. You know, just pull him off his feet with my tongue. Just give him a little surprise.
Like, you're going to try and rip him...
Knock him over, yes.
Knock him over, or...
Like, stick it out, grab onto him, and then pull him down.
Alright. That would be... I'm going to count that as a grapple. So, roll...
Athletics. Oh, no. Oh, yay!
Oh. You actually do manage to knock him over. He falls flat on his face, and it
leaves... Alright, perfect!
Thud.
Now, can I do phase 2 of Ultimate Plan?
Yes. Wait, what is phase 2?
Yep.
Moonbeam? What's the... It's DC 15 on the save. Const. -4. Yeah, you lift your hand up, and out comes a beam of blindingly bright light. It doesn't do much to him, surprisingly. He just kind of shrugs it off as usual. On his turn, he stands up and he lays down his weapon. And he goes, I surrender.
I'm sorry? Did you just say you surrender after all of that?
He goes, what? What can I say? I've already been paid.
So you're saying you don't want to die?
Is there any way to tell how many more HP he has?
What?
How much more HP does he have?
You can roll perception to see how much longer, how much more you think he can fight.
Yeah.
Go ahead and roll perception.
He can fight forever!
This is Arnold Schwarzenegger on steroids!
My response to his surrender is simple. No. It's a very simple response. Well, he's talking to Ronnie. I'm just gonna walk over and I am going to hit him on the head.
So you're going to try to knock him out?
Holy fuck, that actually hit.
Full force swing on his
Can
head.
I say the...
Just full force. Roll for damage.
Damage.
Yeah, okay, we go on quarter staff. Here?
No. Like...
Oh, right, under the roll. Under the roll?
In the chat log. You see where when you clicked on it, it rolled?
Okay, there we go.
Plus 0?
My bad.
What? You conk him on the head, and he raises a hand, and
a
black mass appears. A giant mass of tentacles appears on the ground around.
Great.
Crap.
Great! Cthulhu! Shit. Just what I wanted to get into.
The way you said, great, Cthulhu!
Great!
Do it. Can everyone roll a dex save?
Something tells me that he was a liar.
Fuck me, I'm not
gonna
die!
Antonio, get out of here!
Is an 8 fine, or am I gonna panic like a bitch?
No.
That's what happens.
The tentacle. Oh my god,
yep.
Go ahead. Isn't that your last reroll?
Fuck!
It's safe to say that
Vin's
not your
Stop clapping, Mason, like a retard.
You just got memed on. Alright, So, the tentacles sprout out from the ground and grab you by the legs and start flailing you around. Antonio manages to jump out of the way of them. But both Zottl and
Scrib.
Scrib get grabbed and start getting tossed around, taking.
Holy shit!
All the times, dude. Can we just appreciate?
That would have killed me twice.
I am almost dead.
He just looks up and goes, "You know, I was actually trying to surrender, you people."
And I would have let you if that chameleon hadn't fucking ruined it.
If it wasn't for that darn meddling chameleon.
For them darn kids and their stupid dog.
I just get up and brush myself.
Alright, so.
Oh, I'm still grabbed.
Oh no, you're still grabbed.
Do I take half damage from that? Is that like bludgeoning? Okay.
Yeah, so you would only take half. Alright, so here's the thing. You can attempt to get out by making a strength or dexterity check, but you're still within range to bust.
Me? It's my turn? It's my turn, you said? Okay, I just say, okay, I'm done. And just, like, hang loose.
You just get thrashed about.
I say I won't fight you.
He actually... the tentacle drops you, and it's Antonio's turn.
I don't want to fight either. I have no capabilities of fighting
you. Okay, I'm going over the corner and like leaning up against a wall and like trying to heal up on some wounds.
Yeah, I'm sitting in this corner trying.
Okay, I'm just gonna wriggle out.
For my turn, I'm gonna use. I know it's, like, almost already passed, but I wanted to use whatever the healing one was. Yes.
Oh, the bracelet.
Yeah,
the
just
one,
in case.
Temporary HP.
I'm just gonna wriggle out and say...
Fisticuffs die, plus your proficiency modifier, plus constitution modifier.
Mason, did I wriggle out with that dexterity?
No. You are the tentacle is still holding. However, he just kind of looks at you.
Oh no, I'm not trying to fight him. I'm just trying to get out of the tentacle's grasp. I just don't say anything.
However, if oh damn. However, you see, rushing
is that
down
how many
the steps,
hit points I get?
Or not step. What? No, it's not fisticuffs. It's,
here,
it should say in there. It's, for now just add 6. It's temporary HP, so it doesn't last very long.
This is one.
However, you hear charging down the ladder, Cethus, who runs down, pulls out his crossbow. Hit the wrong button.
Rolling 20.
20. And also rolled as the wrong person. Where is... Huh. Do I not have the ability to control Cephas? No, there we go. He fucking misses. He pulls the crossbow out again, and he misses. Oh my god.
Cephas is gonna fucking die.
However, he pulls off the bandolier he has on his chest, one of his potions, and tosses it. Please don't fail, please don't fail, please don't fail. Fuck! At his feet. And he passes out.
I'm sorry, my character just laughs after seeing that.
The Tiefling, he just kind of puts his staff down and goes, maybe you'll all kill yourself. I didn't even need to be here. And he releases the spell. He goes, all right, none of us can fight anymore, and none of us are going to die today. Zotl done. He leans against the wall and goes, so how's your guys' day going?
I just walk back up the ladder and go into the library.
Sorry about that. I was getting called by my mom. What happened? is that good or is that bad?
Good question. I wasn't prepared.
So, what happened?
Cephas missed.
Okay.
And the Tiefling stopped fighting, leaning against the wall, and was like, so, how's your guys' day going?
Alright, okay.
I'm still in the corner of this, just trying to catch my breath, panting, and
severely beaten. I take out my book and start reading.
He's just like, yeah.
I ask, can I ask if that was the test?
He looks up and goes, yeah. There's a slight problem, though. See, I wasn't given explicit instructions on whether to kill or not to kill. And, Cephas just knocked himself out.
Wait, Cephas just knocked himself out and not the guy who you guys were fighting?
Oh, yes, okay. Cephas knocked himself out.
Okay. Well, all right. Are we still fighting?
No. He's just like, yeah. When he wakes up, tell him I just escaped. I don't know what happened or why he decided to throw a sleep bomb at himself. So, that's awkward. I'm gonna go leave through the ladder. There's a rune upstairs on one of the beds. Just touch it, and it should literally fix the bed. Put, the pillows actually up on top of it, and, the rocks should rescind, and you should be able to leave no problem. Hi. I'm one of the top assassins in the Severani Guild, and I'm slightly insulted. I'm here right now, so I'm just gonna leave and pretend this never happened.
Okay. Well. Good fight. I don't know what to say.
Yeah. We'll. Your guild leader's embarrassed everyone here right now. I don't have words to describe how upset I am that I just witnessed the top interrogator who killed my mentor just knock himself out. So.
Okay. If you don't mind, I'm gonna go finish my dinner.
I just lick my finger and turn the next page of my book.
Okay, I just head upstairs and I don't care anymore.
I go back to the library and I salvage what I can for
books. Is this place still on fire or no?
No. Although there are very big, burn marks.
Okay, yeah, I'm going back to the table to see if everybody's okay, first of all.
I search.
What, Antonio?
I search for any.
It is pretty much 6 now. You come across the rune he was talking about. You notice that there's a bed that has a pillow on the floor and a very clear outline of where it's supposed to go.
Okay, I'm back. I walk downstairs to the table. What's going on there?
Everyone seems to be able to move again. Tevel is chowing down, and all the nobles just look really confused. The one with the knife through him is taking it pretty well.
He's alive?
They're confused.
Like, and moving? He's okay?
Yeah, he's just kind of feeling at his chest, the hole that was there seems to have been mended shut.
Okay, so much for the assassination attempt.
Hey, Mason, do I find any salvageable books?
So are you guys gonna... Okay, now that I see that they're all okay, I head back upstairs into the trapdoor room or whatever. Like, as fast as I can, anyway.
Back to where Sithis was?
What?
What?
I'm going to the trap room where Sithis is.
Yeah, they were here. Yeah, Antonio?
Guess who was texting me?
Who?
His girlfriend. You wanna know what she's asking?
What?
I wanted to... Because I asked if he wanted to come over, and I kinda need to know in the next 30 minutes before my mom says he can't come anymore.
Oh, yeah, that's important.
So is everything okay?
Yeah, Mason.
Ooh.
Smash.
Ooh.
Oh.
And I asked my mom if I'm allowed to move in.
I'm still waiting to see if I found any fucking books yet.
You didn't find any books. Nothing that you hadn't already noticed that wasn't interesting. So I'm gonna have to be heading out soon. Sithis wakes up and he looks at you guys and he goes, "Where did the typhoon go?"
He escaped.
Where the fuck do you think?
Oh.
Okay, Mason. Do you want me to come too?
I'd rather you just chill at the new house.
Because apparently I'm allowed to go too. Mason, I'm going. They're making cookies.
Oh my god.
Let's go. I need a shower.
Okay.
Yeah, so do I. I'll see you guys later.